Hello friends, welcome to engineering tutorial. So we'll continue our discussion with television engineering. So far we have discussed various concepts related to color, image, related to the picture quality in television. In this video we are going to discuss about the sound characteristics, an equally important component of television transmission and reception, that is audio and video. We know so far we have been discussing about the picture aspect. Now we'll discuss about the sound characteristics. So as we all know, the two main components of television, they are sound, audio, the picture, the video. So sound is an important characteristics of a television system. Actually, we can say that the sound quality is actually comparatively, it is more important as compared to the video quality. Okay, because poor quality sound, it can disrupt the viewing experience. Okay, and for the experience, the television experience or any viewing experience to be good, the quality of sound should be very high. So by good quality sound, I mean that it should be free from noise and distortions and should have a comfortable volume. Okay, and in order to achieve these levels for good quality, there are two important characteristics of sound which have to be taken into consideration. First is intensity, second is frequency. Okay, intensity and frequency of sound. Now we know that sound basically is a sound wave. It consists of a series of compressions and rarefactions. Okay, and the basic sound wave, it is like any other wave that we have already discussed. It consists of a particular amplitude of the wave, then the wavelength, the distance between two consecutive points on the wave, and then another important thing, which is the time period, the time taken for one complete completion of the wave cycle, complete cycle of the wave. Okay, so intensity of sound, it is the power carried by the sound waves per unit area in the direction perpendicular to that area. It is also called as acoustic intensity and has a unit of watt per square meter. As it is given in the definition, the power carried per unit area. So watt per square meter. The unit of power watt, the unit of area square meter. And in order to measure sound, a particular reference level is set, which is in terms of decibels, where the reference is taken as an intensity of 1 picowatt per square meter, and that is taken as the reference of 0 dB. Okay, the logarithmic unit comes into play. And as per this 0 dB reference of 1 picowatt per square meter, whispering, talking in a very low voice, that measures about 20 decibel. Normal speech is about 50 decibel. Thunderstorms, that is about 100 decibel, and so on. Basically, sound intensities above 130 decibel can cause irritation, pain, and damage to the ear. Okay, then the mathematical expression of sound intensity, it is given by the expression I, which is sound intensity, 2 pi square f square delta square rho c. Okay, where f is equal to frequency of sound, delta is amplitude of the sound wave, rho is the density of the medium through which the sound is moving, and c is the speed of sound. Okay, the speed of sound. This is the mathematical expression of sound intensity. Another important characteristic feature is the frequency of sound. Okay, Frequency of sound is like the number of compressions and rarefactions passing through a point given per unit time. So it is directly related with the time period, which is the time taken by the sound wave to complete one complete wave cycle or oscillation. And the mathematical expression of frequency is the reciprocal of the time period. It has a unit of hertz. And we all know the velocity of sound, the speed of sound, is given by wavelength by time period. So we can say frequency is basically equal to v by lambda, okay, velocity by wavelength, or we can say c by lambda, where c is the speed of the sound in a particular medium. Okay, the audible frequency of sound is basically from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, which is called as the baseband of sound. And the frequency range of human voice, it ranges from 110 to 2000 hertz. Okay, so another important feature which is related with sound is, which is particularly important in television systems or sound systems, is bass and treble. So bass is particularly associated with low frequency notes. Okay, we all know that music or any sound, it consists of high frequency and low frequency components. So bass is basically associated with low frequency notes and treble with high frequency notes. So the low frequency notes, it provides depth in the audio. And when we increase the bass, we are basically boosting the low frequency components. And treble provides sharpness, which is done by enhancing or boosting the high frequency components. So depending on our requirement, whether we like bass or treble, we can adjust it accordingly. So these are some of the basic concepts related to sound. So these are just the introductory concept. When we'll discuss about television transmission and television reception, we'll discuss about them in detail. Here we are just, you know, covering the basic things, so that when we discuss these things in detail, we don't have to cover the basics again. So watch these basic introductory videos first, and then we'll go in detail about all the other components of television transmission, reception, the signal processing, the individual components associated with sound and video transmission reception. So it's a very vast topic. Okay, so I hope you like this video, and please subscribe my channel Engineering Tutorial for more such videos related to engineering, science and technology. Have a great day. Thank you very much.